We should start. Welcome today to the first diverse talk. It's about distribution, and Martin Krischert is talking about the Lecture to Go project today. And yeah, let's go.
Well, good morning, everyone. I want to talk about audio and video content distribution we have developed at the University of Hamburg. What I want to say, I have to talk something about the history of the project, about access options, distribution, sharing, etc. A short demo, the underlying technology, the server architecture, in short, and maybe an kind of outlook. Well, let's go. University of Hamburg is, as you can see, distributed all over the large city, second largest city in Germany. The longest distance between these locations is around 40 kilometers, I suppose 30 and a bit miles. And we have 500 rooms or a bit more to handle. So video lecture capturing was our goal. We did develop a complete workflow with capturing, annotations, processing, delivering. We started in 2007. I got a request from a professor who had to organize the GMW conference. The GMW is it's called in German Gesellschaft für Medien in der Wissenschaft. Translated, it would be like Society for Media and Sciences, so like a society of e-learning, for e-learning. Well, we started in 2007. In the meantime, there are 30 mobile capture systems. We're recording dual stream video, DV and photo JPEG, and we are processing four different distribution formats, MPEG-4, a large video, a small one, a podcast one, AAC, and MP3. Well, but the main topic will be the Lecture to Go portal. It's a project since 2008, paid mainly by tuition fees. I got luck. I got one engineer, Java Sturm, and one research assistant to build this project. The web portal is online since August 2009. Actually, we have 4,500 recordings. Nearly 2,000 recordings per year. I've learned my lesson yesterday, so my first mock-up from 2008, it's published. it should be a mock-up of the capture system. So in the rectangle, you see the recording PC, instead of has been a MacBook or MacBook Pro, a VGA to USB converter, MIPIFAN, an external hard disk. This has been the real first version to record the GMV 2007. And these are our actual cases. This will technically details, frameware inside, yes. Our distribution formats, presentation, lecturer side by side, annotations, small podcast format. You can change the directions, left side, right side presentation. Well. Um, in the end of 2007, we had 150 recordings. The question was what to do with this amount, what to do with lecture recordings in general. So we decided to develop a media content management system to handle this amount of data. We voted for open access. Indeed, nearly 50% of the recordings are public available. Of course, you can put content closed inside, but it's like a digital rights management light. So there's a password, an encrypted link, and the videos are not visible for normal guests on the platform. We have a role-based concept behind. Well, the guest who enters the platform does only see the open access content. Students, of course, have access to a partially closed content via their password. The producer is able to manage the complete video. He can set the access to well, I'll show you later. The coordinator has the same rights, and he is also managing the producers and the series. Well, and the administrator, you can imagine, he's the most powerful person of the system. Quick view on the producer options. There's some bibliographical information, the name of the lecturer, the title of the presentation, and the symbols from the left mean from the left to the right mean. Download. If it's green, it's free. It's okay. There's a key. If it's open, it's able to see. If it's closed, not. Maybe with a password. Here's the download error. This icon shows if there are captures inside the video or not. Here you can enter descriptions, annotations, and well, this one just deletes the entry. So what about distribution, sharing, embedding, subscription? We deliver all distribution methods. We can stream on demand or live. If you don't do anything, it will be streaming on demand. So there's a bit of security. This stream normally nobody can copy. It's a bit safe, let's say so. Streaming on live is also possible, and the download option, of course, too. What about sharing embedding? We can inform our social networks. Citation to go. I will show you in a few minutes. We have embed codes to embed videos, for example, in LMS systems. At Hamburg, we are using COMSI, it's a homebrew system, and OLAT from Switzerland. The subscription of three series is possible via RSS feeds. You can, for example, put RSS feeds in the iTunes U portal of the University of Hamburg. Well, short demo. I hope I...
Schnell.
Well, there we are. You can vote for English or German as a language. Not every translation is correct. To show it's possible and it's easy to do in theory. There are three main categories, new ones, a bit like YouTube, popular and random. In the menu bar, you can switch between lecture series and conferences. About tells something about the platform. News, as it says. So let's start one with a search option. That's been from Jan Clausen. He had developed the graphical interface, more or less. And what I can show you is you can see some metadata, duration, which format, how large, how many views, nearly 4,000, which license. You get some informations. You have different sharing options for social media, citation to go, I've promised to show. So you're looking for an interesting section. Click at begin. You can imagine another one at the end of your section, another click, you've got a web link. And this is our citation. So it's just the section of the video. In the URL, you can see 352.645. That are the seconds of the video. So let's go back to the full video. Other things you can do: drugs, nearly the same as citation to go. You can make chapters, of course. Comments too. And if you move the slider, it's adjusted accordingly. Okay. Well, you also have links, embed codes for embedding in other platforms or in other websites. Of course, you have a download option. Here you see our four formats. This means subscription. That's what I mean. It's not totally translated. We have missed something. So here you can get your RSS feeds. Some questions at this time. Okay.
Just how enthusiastically do your lecturers take to this?
Pardon?
How enthusiastic are your lecturers in using it?
Our lecturers?
Yeah.
It's well accepted. There are departments which are happier with this, others not. For example, yes, economics are quite busy. Mm-hmm. Nature science is also mathematics, informatics, of course. Yeah.
Do you provide additional training or support to lecturers?
No, nothing. Nothing. Oh. Mac user on the wrong system, but okay, I could sign in to show the administration side. Just to show you. Last file. No. Well, where have you been? So what a bit about technology. The player is called Strobe Media Playback. It's based on an open source media framework. It's able to play Flash and HTML5. For streaming, we are using browser streaming server. The portal is based on Liferay 6.1, etc. It's an enterprise portal software. It's open source. It has a large community. And the whole portal is based on industrial standards, MPEG-4, H.264, Adobe Flash, HTML5, Java, Spring, Ajax. Well, our server architecture, a bit abstract, repository and streaming and the web server are mirrored. Of course, there's a download server, an upload server, development devices, backup via tape library. Nearly everything can be virtualized. Not the streaming. For streaming, you need a really powerful machine. Well, Outlook. What we need, we have 30 mobile systems, we can't manage them anymore. This system doesn't scale, so therefore we need a second automated workflow. I wanted processing, indexing, segmentation, scheduling, monitoring, of course. And, well, what comes in mind is, of course, OpenCast Matterhorn. Auto tracking is another project. What about the Lecture to Go portal? We have to make a new light design, more search possibilities, better navigation, and we are going to be open source in autumn 2013. Well, and who's interested, please feel free to contact us. We can give you a kind of alpha distribution to play with, or a demo account to play with the system. Thank you very much.
So, are there any questions? I see, already one.
If you look at the 4,500 lectures that you captured over the last few years,
yeah,
how much are they used? Do you have usage statistics, some average usage, or some kind of statistic Saying yes, how much are viewed?
We have usage is growing nearly exponentially. So at the moment we have nearly 1,000 visitors per day. That's no, what's missing are fine statistical methods to get better statistics.
Okay, further questions? No? I got one. So about your portal, is it responsive designed? So when you watch it on a mobile device, for instance, does it adapt to this screen sizes?
Pardon, I didn't understand you acoustically.
So is your portal designed in a responsive manner? So if you open it with your handy, for instance, or your tablet, does it fit to the screen sizes? So are you planning to do it in the future, if not?
No, interesting point. An app is also in development. We've got some help from our MIN department, mathematics, nature and science, and they are doing this job for us.
Was it a strategic decision to use an app instead of a mobile web page, or was it just because everybody does apps?
It's been a gift, so what do you do with the gift? You take it or leave it. So we would have voted for a mobile site, of course, yeah, instead of an app.
Okay, one last question. Ah, there.
Hello. So did I understand well that you are planning to make it open source?
Yes. Or what?
But at this moment, it's alpha version. So if I would like to have a code, I'd just send you a mail.
Yes, okay. Yes.
That's good. Are you planning to publish this?
In autumn. First date has been 13th of August, but I think it's too early. So we need a bit more for documentation, especially.
And the application of the app itself will be open source as well?
Yes, the app must be open source as well. Yeah, should be.
Okay, very nice. Thank you.
Okay. Thank us again for the speaker.